Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how to use Cake.buid in an Azure Dev Ops pipeline to generate a static website. Si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de cette vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. So in today's demo, I want to use Cake as an automation process to execute steps on the build machine to generate my website. So you could go on the website Cake, and it's in C#, so that's why I picked it. I was feeling very comfortable with it. So if you go here in the Get Started, you will find all the instruction required to understand how to use it. So here we see that we will need a PowerShell script named build.ps1 and the actual build script named build.cake. If we go here in the example repository, in this repository, you will find all the files required for our projects. And if you go on the WIAM website and you go in the documentation, you have a section here for deployment that use Cake. And here again, you will have other instruction on how to use Cake to generate WIAM website. So let's get started. To start that process with Azure DevOps, we need an Azure Pipeline YAML file. And it's a good practice to put the deployment stuff in a folder. So let's start by creating a new folder. We'll name it deployment. And then we'll add a new file, Azure Pipeline, in it. Now we are ready to get started. So first thing, we want to be triggered on a commit on master. So let's put that trigger. Next, because all the components I will be using are in .NET Core, I will install .NET Core. So here I am. I create a variable. So if I want to update in the future the version of the SDK I'm using, it will be simple that way. Then instead of using the Ubuntu machine that comes by default, I will use a Windows one. And the first step will be to install the .NET Core. Now my build server is ready. So like explained on the Cake website, we need to execute that build.ps1 file. So we'll create a new step calling a PowerShell command and we'll execute that file. We need also to add the file to our repository. So let's do this. So we'll create a new file and we'll put it at the root and we'll grab the code from the GitHub repository. There it is. If you look at the script, it's very simple to understand. It's kind of a bootstrap, so it will install Cake and then it will execute by default build.cake. But of course, you have many different parameters and you could pass something else. So the next step will be to add this build cake file. So let's add it. The cake file I'm using here is a bit different because when I was executing the script, I was noticing in my logs some warning. So to remove those, I specify here the version of the package I'm installing. So the way we read this is we install NuGet package, so WIAM will be installed, and then the cake.wiam will be installed. And then we'll just executing the command WIAM, passing the settings. So great, now we have our bootstrap to install the component we need. We have our build command. So at the end of the PowerShell step, the website is now generated. So we need to copy it in a different folder. So let's do this with a copy file step, just like this. So I'm copying the output folder to the artifact staging directory. We're mostly there. The only thing missing is that we need to publish those files. So let's add the last step for now, and it will be a publish artifact step. So for the last step, we'll be publishing the build artifact, publishing that specific folder. So there it is. We have all the components required. We are ready to start building our build pipeline. Perfect. We have now everything in order to set up our build pipeline. So I will commit and push, and we'll get back to you on the Azure DevOps website. Here I am in Azure DevOps. Now, what I need to do is create a build pipeline. So let's go there, and in pipeline, select build. Because I have nothing, it's a brand new project, I will create a new pipeline. Now, I need to select the source of my code. In my case, it's in GitHub, so I will need to authenticate and pick my repository. Now that the handshaking is done, my Azure pipeline has access to my GitHub repository. So now I need to specify where is that Azure pipeline.yaml file is. I already have one, remember? So I will select here the existing Azure pipeline. I'm staying in master. I don't have multiple branches, but if you do, you could specify one here. And the path then, it's deployment Azure pipeline. Excellent. Click continue. And that's the file we created earlier. Fantastic. You still have the chance to change it if you want, but in our case, everything looks fine, so we just need to run it. Great! The build was successful. Our artifacts are now published and ready to be used. In the next video, I will show you how to build that release pipeline to deploy in Azure.